Hey guys, Mask Collector here from BZ Power. I just figured I would do a review of my solid 14 karat gold Bionicle Kanohi Hau mask. Right here is just a standard Kanohi Hau. Just kind of show you for anyone who doesn't know. This is the piece I'll be reviewing today. Just, I have it inside our box still. You'll see that the actual gold piece is an exact replica of this. It just has holes on the top because it also has a necklace. So we'll go over that now. I'll set this aside. So first thing is this neat little box it comes with. This is pretty rare. Like I said, there's only 5 ever released to the public. So with this being said, the box itself, of course, has a Lego logo on it, and then it has this gold trim around the edges. You can kind of see just highlighted. Other than that, it's just kind of like a standard box. It's got a little thumb tab on it here to help you open it. Closes down securely, and it's just a plain, it's a hard kind of a plastic box. And now we'll go ahead and take a look on the inside. So here's the prize piece of my collection currently. I've always wanted this mask. It's been about a 10-year process of getting this mask, of asking people who have them, trying to get responses. This mask originally was owned by one of the very first BZ Power administrators. So this piece is pretty rare. I got it from the second owner, and this is now mine, so it makes it the third owner. Here are the holes in the top of the piece. You can see it's a very, very nice piece, really heavy considering that it's only this big. On the inside, you can see there's the code 4CR. Once again, yeah, this is not gold plated, it's actually solid Kanohi. Solid gold. I mean, you can see it's an exact replica. Size, proportion, everything. It's a perfect replica. The box itself on the inside has kind of a felt, a very nice just case on the inside. Has little indents for where the mask will fit perfectly. Underneath, I actually have the necklace underneath because I don't like to have it near the mask. I don't want it to scratch the mask. So here's the necklace. It's just a simple chain necklace. Very nice. I was surprised considering that it's pretty small. It does its job on me, whereas I'm not a very young child. It doesn't fit around my neck very well. But yeah. So this piece will actually go through the side of the mask, up and around, and into the necklace. But I just wanted to do a quick review for you. I can go into some more depth and detail in the forums themselves about this piece. But currently, it is the pride and joy of my collection. I'm trying to get the platinum of Oki. Excuse me. I've messaged the guy multiple times. He's actually holding the piece for me, and I'm going to meet him in person in about March and hopefully buy the mask from him. So, assuming all of my funds come together from that, then it'll be perfect. I actually have a trade topic, and I'm selling almost every piece of Bionicle History that I have to help fund the Platinum of Oki. But for now, this is the pride and joy of my collection. It's actually, I weighed it on the scale, and the solid gold mask, to kind of put it into perspective, if you have a standard Kanohi Hau, it weighs about 1/8 of an ounce. So in order to have the same weight that is on this piece, you would need 8 masks in your hand, because this mask actually weighs 1 1/8 ounce. So you'd need 8 of these in your hand to have kind of the same weight. So this piece is pretty valuable. I've seen them go on eBay a few times for over $2,000 each, so it'll be pretty nice if I get myself in a bind, but I really doubt I'll ever sell my Pride and Joy. So thanks for watching the review. If you liked it, go ahead and check out my trade topic, because I'm going to be selling all my Bionicle sets there. I'll have it linked in the description. And if you have any questions, go ahead and ask it in this topic. It's my solid gold Kanohi Hau review topic. So once again, I'll kind of show you some more of the detailed pieces. The inside, you can see the little metal plates. It's a pretty nice piece. I was so happy to finally have this piece for my collection, because I've worked very, very hard trying to contact people about obtaining this piece. So there it is, and I hope you guys enjoyed. Like I said, if you have any questions, any comments, feel free to drop them by, and we'll see if I can help you out. So until next time, thanks for tuning in, guys.